Hello guys, welcome back. I'm ChowChow2025. Today we're diving straight into the Wan 2.2 image-to-video 14B model. I'm going to show you how to build the most complete, fastest and most VRAM-efficient workflow using mostly comfy core components. This is 100% beginner-friendly, and you can download the final workflow later, link in the description below. First, let's download the necessary models. You can find all the links in the video description. We are using the Wan 2.2 model GGUF. We choose GGUF quantized models because they are much smaller and incredibly VRAM efficient. Access the Hugging Face link. Unlike Wan 2.1, Wan 2.2 uses two sequential models, high noise and low noise. You need both GGUF files. I recommend choosing a quantization based on your VRAM. I'm downloading Q5KS for both. Place both GGUF files in your ComfyUI/models/diffusion models folder. Remember, they run sequentially, so you only need VRAM to accommodate the single largest model. For the VAE model, use the same VAE as Wan 2.1. Download it if you don't have it and save it in ComfyUI/models/VAE. The link is near the Wan 2.2 models. To dramatically increase speed, we need the Light2V LoRA. The link is in the description. Save this LoRA model in ComfyUI/models/LoRAs. I'm using rank 64 and 128 here, but adjust the rank based on your available VRAM. For text encoders, we'll use the WAN 2.1 encoders. Download the UMT5XXLPF16.SAFA tensor and save it to ComfyUI/models/text encoders. Lastly, the Clip Vision model, we'll use Clip Vision H from WAN 2.1. Save it in ComfyUI/models/Clip Vision. Before we build the workflow, we need three custom nodes. Open your manager, go to Custom Nodes Manager, search for ComfyUI GGUF and install it. This is absolutely crucial for running GGUF models. Restart ComfyUI when prompted. Install Video Helper Suite, VHS, and ComfyUI KJ Nodes with the same step. Now we have the models and nodes. Let's build this efficient workflow quickly. Add two UNet Loader GGUF nodes. Select the high noise GGUF for the top one and the low noise GGUF for the bottom one. Add a load clip node. Select the UMT5XXLPF16.SAFA tensor and set the type to WAN. Add two load LoRA nodes. Select the Light2V LoRA for both. Connect them, high noise UNet to the upper LoRA, low noise UNet to the lower LoRA. Connect the clip output to the clip input on both LoRAs. Add two model sampling SD3 nodes. Connect the output of the upper LoRA to the upper sampling node and the lower LoRA to the lower sampling node. Add two clip text encode nodes for your positive and negative prompts. Connect the upper LoRA's clip output to both of them. Add a load image node. Select the image you want to animate here. Add a resize image V2 node. Connect the load image output here. Set your desired size. I'm setting 480 width and 848 height with keep proportion crop. Add the WAN image to video node. Connect the resize image V2 output to its start image width and height parameters. Add a load clip vision node and select clip vision H. Add a clip vision encode node. Connect the resize image V2 and load clip vision to this node. Connect the clip vision encode output to the WAN image to video node. Add a load VAE node, selecting the VAE WAN 2.1 file. Connect the load VAE output to the WAN image to video node. Finally, connect your positive and negative prompts to the WAN image to video node. Add the first K-sampler, advanced node. Set step 8 CFG1 sampler name LCM. Set end at step 4 or half of total step. Enable return with leftover noise. Connect the high noise model sampling SD3 output to the model input. Connect the latent and prompt inputs from the WAN image to video node. Duplicate this K sampler and place it below. Change the parameters, add noise disable. Set start at step 4, the same as the previous K sampler's end step. Set end step to 8 or your total step count. Set return with leftover noise to disable. Connect the high noise K sampler output to this node's latent input. Connect the low noise model sampling SD3 output to this node's model input. Connect the prompt inputs from the WAN image to video node. add a VAE decode node, connect the output of the lowercase sampler advanced and the load VAE node into it. Lastly, add a video combine node. Connect the VAE decode output here. Set your desired output settings. I set the frame rate to 25 FPS. Now let's run this workflow. The result is pretty good. This run only took me about 14 to 18 minutes on my RTX 4060 Ti 16GB of VRAM. Even better, the very next generation after the models were already loaded only took 8 to 10 minutes. That's fast. I was using Q5KS and I'm confident I could push to Q5KM or Q6 next time. To wrap up, here's a quick visual comparison of Wan 2.2 vs. Wan 2.1 using the exact same prompt and settings. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and comment. Please subscribe to ChowChow 2025 for more efficient ComfyUI workflows. See you again on the next episode and have a nice day.